Yeah, good morning, dear students. We are in module 5, that is custom duty. In the last class, we have discussed, actually these are the topics to be covered in module 5. Already we have discussed in the previous class. So in the last class, we have finished the concept introduction to the custom duty, the definitions of various concepts or various terms covered under customs duty. Then one of the important concept we have discussed in previous class, that is types of duty. There are 14 types of custom duties are there, mainly basic custom duty, additional custom duty, or also called as countervailing duty, CVD, then special custom duty. So many other types of custom duty already we have discussed, that is very important. And today's class, we will concentrate on two important concepts again. One is the circumstances of levy of custom duties. In which are all circumstances custom duty is leviable, and in which are all circumstances custom duty is not chargeable, everything we'll discuss. And one more important concept, exemptions from custom duty. What are all the types of exemptions available for the custom duty, that we will discuss. And in next class, that is in Monday's class, we will concentrate on valuations under customs. So under valuations under customs, we have two things. One is valuation of imported goods, another one is valuation of export goods. Then we have the problems in module 5, that is problems on valuation of imported goods only. So we'll discuss. So we'll begin the concept today with the circumstances of levy of custom duties. So circumstances of levy of customs duty, these circumstances mainly given on, or in which are all circumstances the custom duty is leviable or levied, that is mentioned under the section 12 of the Customs Act 1962. The custom duty is considered to be levied on the goods and not on the person. So very important, custom duty is levied on the goods, which goods you are importing and which goods you are exporting. So based on your custom duty, that is maybe import duty as maybe or it may be export duty, is decided. Custom duty is not decided on the basis of person. It is decided or levied on the goods and not on the person importing the goods or paying the duty. So it is clear that now it is clear that custom duty is levied only on the goods and not on the person who is importing or exporting the goods. So mainly section 12 of the Customs Duty Act 1962 speaks about the circumstances of levy of custom duty. Next, circumstances of levy of custom duty. There are three stages for the imposition of taxes and duties, especially in the custom duty. Instead of tax, we are mainly call it as duties. It may be import duty or it may be export duty. So mainly we have three stages for the imposition of taxes and duties. So that three important stages are: one is levy, another one is assessment, third one is collection. So all taxes and duties are imposed in three stages, that is levy, collection, as well as assessment. So we'll discuss what do you mean by levy, what do you mean by assessment, and what do you mean by collection. So first stage is levy. So levy is the stage where the declaration of the liability is made. So how much custom duty is payable, that is the liability of the custom duty, that declarations are mainly given in the levy stage. So levy is the stage where the declaration of the liability is made, and the person or the properties and the person or properties in respect of which tax or duty is to be levied and charged. First of all, declaration of liability is made, as well as the person or the properties in respect of which the tax or duty is to be levied and charged, for whom it is charged, everything mentioned under the first stage, that is levy stage. And the second stage is an assessment. So assessment is the procedure of quantifying the amount of liability. Very important. What do you mean by quantifying the amount of liability? See, quantifying in the first stage, levy stage, only declaration of liability is made. But in the second stage, that is assessment, assessment is the procedure of quantifying the amount of liability. Quantifying means exactly in numbers we are calculating how much custom duty is liable to pay by the person who imported the goods. So it is the procedure of quantifying the amount of liability. The liability of tax, liability to tax or duty does not depend upon the assessment. It is nothing but quantifying the amount of liability. And the third one is, third stage is the collection. The final stage is where the tax or duty is actually collected. Simple it is. So first stage, declaration of liability is made. Second stage, quantifying the amount of liability. And the third stage, where the tax or duty is actually collected at the time of importing the goods. So the collection of tax or duty may for administrative or other reason be postponed to a later time, as done in the case of excise duty, wherein the liability towards the duty arises upon the manufacture of excisable goods and duty is collected only upon removal of goods from the factory. So for you, important thing is collection is nothing but where the tax or where the custom duty is actually collected. That is the final stage of the imposition of taxes and duties, that is collection stage. So these are the three important stages: levy, assessment and collection of tax or duty. These are the three important stages of imposition of taxes and duties. Next, again continuation only, point and circumstances of levy of custom duty. There are some points, 5 to 6 points are there, where exactly or in which circumstances levy of custom duty is charged. Already I told that it mainly talks about section 12 mainly talks about the circumstances of levy of custom duty. So we'll discuss the various points. So first point is, it is levied on the goods imported or exported such rates as may be prescribed. See here, the first circumstance is custom duty is levied on the goods imported, or custom duty is levied on the goods exported in such rates as may be prescribed. So rate is prescribed by the parliament, or it is prescribed under the Customs Act 1962 as well as under the Customs Tariffs Act 1975, or any other law for the time being in force on goods imported into and exported from India. So simple meaning is, duties of custom shall be levied at such rate as may be prescribed in the Customs Act or may be prescribed in the Customs Tariffs Act 1975. Second one, government goods treated at par with the non-government goods. See here, very important, there is no much difference between government goods and non-government goods. Even government goods as well as non-government goods are treated as equally. That means the provision of subsection 1 shall apply in respect of all goods belongs to the government as they apply in respect of goods non-belongs to the government. So what is the rule applicable for the goods which are imported by non-government? The same rule is applicable for the goods which is imported by government also. So that means government goods is treated at par. That means it is treated equally with the non-government goods. There is no much difference between the government goods and non-government goods under the Customs Act 1962. It mainly mentioned under the section 12 and subsection 1. So third circumstances, no general exemptions on the goods imported by government, specific notifications are issued. See, in the previous point we have discussed that there is no much difference between the government goods and non-government goods. Now even exemption also, no general exemptions on goods imported by the government. Everything are same for government goods as well as non-government goods. Custom duty is leviable, but exceptions are there. There is no general exemptions on goods imported by government, but imports by Indian Navy, specific equipment required by the police, Ministry of Defense, Coastal Guard, etc. If these in these cases, any import of goods means it is considered as for the public interest, that time exemption may be available. Otherwise, there is no general exemptions on goods imported by government. All other goods other than the imports by Indian Navy, specific equipments required by police, Ministry of Defense, Coastal Guard, etc. In this case, it is fully exempt from custom duty by virtue of specific notification subject to fulfillment of conditions and or procedure set out in the notification. Other than this, any other goods which is imported by government also, exemption is not available. Custom duty is leviable. That is the third circumstances. Then the fourth circumstances, very important, that is section 13, no duty on pilfered goods. I will explain what you mean by pilfered goods in the next slide, but before that, no custom duty is charged on pilfered goods. Means if any imported goods are pilfered, after the unloading as well as before the proper officer has made an order for the clearance, nothing but after the uploading, after the unloading of goods, or before the clearance from the proper officer for the home consumption, any pilfered goods are there, for that no duty is charged, no custom duty is charged. So what do you mean by pilfered goods? We'll discuss in the next slide. So pilferage of goods under section 13. Say pilfer means steal something. It is nothing but stealed goods. That is typically of small value. Minor theft is considered as pilfered goods. Typically a small value. Theft goods or stealed goods, especially with the small quantities, are considered as pilfer goods. Like taking a roll of toilet paper out of a public bathroom or napkins. These are considered as a small theft or minor theft. For these, custom duty is not chargeable. So pilferage refers to a petty theft. Petty theft means a small in quantity. It is to steal the goods, especially in small quantities. Importer not liable if pilferage takes place. So for pilferage goods, no custom duty is levied. That is the fourth circumstances. Then fifth circumstances, section 22, reduced duty on damaged goods. At the time of importing the goods, any goods which is damaged, any imported goods had been damaged or had deteriorated at any time before or during the unloading of the goods in India, then reduced duty is chargeable. That means full custom duty is not chargeable. See, any imported goods without damage, 10% is there. Means if the goods are identified as damaged goods or deteriorated goods, that time reduced duty is paid. Reduced duty in the sense maybe lesser than 10%, maybe 0.5% or 1 or 2% reduction may take place in the case of custom duty. So reduced duty on damaged goods is also one of the circumstances of levy of custom duty. Then the last one, section 23, remission of duty on destroyed goods. Damaged goods is different, destroyed goods is different. So remission of duty on destroyed goods. Remission means waiver or cancellation of duty. Sometime there may be a waiver or cancellation of duty also. It is not the case of reduced duty. It is waiver or cancellation of duty. In which case? In the case of destroyed goods. Section 23, subsection 1 of the Customs Act provides for remissions of duty on imported goods lost other than the pilferage or destroyed. Imported goods lost or destroyed. If such loss or destruction is at any time before the clearance for home consumption, similarly, remission has to be given even if the loss is due to negligence of the importer. Any destroyed taken place in the imported goods means remission of duty or waiver or cancellation of duty also applicable. This is also one of the circumstances of levy of customs duty. So this is a continuation only. Custom duty not leviable in certain cases. Some six circumstances we have seen. So here with the sections, in these cases, custom duty is not leviable. No duty on pilfered goods. Pilfered goods means minor theft, relatively at a smaller value. Reduced duty on damaged goods, remission of duty on destroyed goods, and plus no duty on relinquishment of the title of the goods. Any changes taken place in the title of the goods means no duty, no custom duty is levied. So this much you can write if the question is asked for the question is asked relating to circumstances of levy of customs duty. Means 6 points you can write, that 3 stages: levy, assessment, collection stages. There are three stages you can explain, 6 points you can include, and these points you can include, and you can write. And even these points you can write, even for exemptions under custom duty also, these points you can mention. That we will discuss now. What are all the exemptions available for the customs duty? So exemptions from the custom duty, mainly there are two exemptions available from the custom duty. One is general exemptions, another one is the special exemptions. Very simple, exemptions from the custom duty, mainly we have two types of exemptions. One is general exemptions, another one is special exemptions. We'll see what do you mean by general exemptions. General exemptions, it is done by notification in official gazette. It is normally done in the notification in official gazette, and it is done normally if the central government is satisfied. See, normally central government will specifies the general exemptions for certain goods imported. That normally central government done this general exemptions given by the central government normally if the government is satisfied that imported goods with the imported goods are imported mainly for the public interest, means they believe that exemption may be required for such goods. So that is necessary in the public interest, especially like imports of imports by Indian Navy or specific equipments required by police or Ministry of Defense, Coastal Guard, etc. In this case, it is considered that the goods imported for the public interest, that time general exemptions may be given. So exempt generally either absolutely or full exemptions may be available or subject to conditions. Maybe a partial exemption available under general exemptions with the certain conditions. General exemptions are in respect of user of goods. Who is using the particular imported goods? Based on that, general exemption is available. For example, I have given the example of Navy, Indian Navy importing the goods, maybe a Coastal Guard, maybe a police department are importing the goods, means it is considered for it is for the public interest. In that case, general exemption is mainly given based on the user of goods. Who is going to use that particular imported goods? Based on that, general exemption is given. Next, special exemptions. Special exemptions, it is done by the special order. General exemptions, actually order given in the gazetted officer, but special exemptions, it is done by special order or it is done in exceptional circumstances. General exemptions, normally it is given by the central government if the government is satisfied that imported goods is for the public interest, means they will give the general exemptions. But a special exemption, it is done by the special order and it is done in exceptional circumstances, and such exceptional circumstances to be stated in the order. Then only special exemptions may be given for the goods which are imported from other country. Specific exemptions are in respect of various product. General exemption is given mainly based on the user of the goods, but specific exemptions are given for the various products. So no duty shall be collected if the amount of duty leviable is equal to or less than 100. It may be applicable for general exemption as well as for special exemptions. Any no duty shall be collected if the amount of duty leviable or liability of the custom duty is equal to or less than 100, means no duty shall be collected. That is also exempt. 100, less than 100 means it is considered as exempt. So exemptions question, if they ask relating to custom duty, means you can write general exemptions, you can write special exemptions. Also you can write no duty on pilfered goods, reduced duty on damaged goods, no duty, remission of duty on destroyed goods. That points also you can write under the exemptions of custom duty. This is same explanation. Exemption from custom duty, two exemptions, general exemptions and special exemptions. General exemptions normally notified in the official gazette, exempt generally either absolute full amount or subject to such condition as may be specified in the notification. Goods of any specified descriptions from the whole or any part of the duty customs leviable thereon. But special exemptions in each case, special order in each case, by special order in each case exempt from payment of duty any goods which duty is levable only under circumstances of any exceptional nature to be stated in such order. No duty shall be collected if the amount of duty levable is equal to or less than rupees 100. This is about exemption from custom duty. One concept is pending, that is valuations under customs. Again, important concept. Valuations under customs, we have two important valuations under customs. One is valuation of imported goods and another one is valuation of exported goods. So that thing we will discuss in Monday's class so that we can finish module 5 also. So we have problems in module 5. That problem we will discuss later. Immediately after the valuations, valuation under customs, I will go to the module 6, that is completely theory. I will finish module 6, then I will concentrate problems on module 2, module 4, and module 5. Maybe module 2, module 3, and module 5. So, in the next class, we'll concentrate on valuation of imports, that is valuation of imported goods as well as valuation of exported goods. Thank you very much. Enough for today's class. See, audio narration I will share in the WhatsApp group. When you suppose if you are hearing for audio narration means, see, sometime in the slide, slight pause may be there, but doesn't mean that audio is not recorded in that particular slide. Wait for some time. Definitely you can hear for the narration part, that is audio explanation. Then only you move to the next slide. Otherwise, my sincere advice is I am sharing the video with you all, or I will share the YouTube link also with you. Suppose I am sharing the YouTube link means download the video, and so that you can watch the video, you can listen for the explanation anytime, even if the data is not available also. Once if it is downloaded, means you can view the video or you can watch the class. Otherwise, whatever video I am uploading in the WhatsApp group, download, save in one particular place, so that whenever if you are free, you can hear for the class or you can watch the explanation part also. So my face you can see in the explanation part, so that you can feel like it is like a classroom teaching. So instead of listening for audio narration, go for the videos, download the video, save in one folder and listen for the class. Meanwhile, if you have any doubt, means please ask, feel free to ask anytime. So thank you very much. Stay home, stay safe, and keep learning every time. Thank you. Meet you in the next class, that is in the next week. Thank you.